The following program contains adult situations. Viewer discretion is advised. The following video may contain content and/or language which may be considered unsuitable for younger viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
Presents.
Good evening, my name is Eric.
I'm Michael Bublé.
I'm Sam, Microsoft Sam.
Hi, I'm Pinkie Pie, and
I'm Felix the Cat. Took the day since we did a Golden Book biography at Walmart, and now we are going to read a Taylor Swift book.
Why?
Because, in honor of the Eras Tour that is coming to a big screen, and that's why we are going to read it, just for you.
So Felix, do you want me to read this book for you?
Yes, Eric, we are ready for you to read this book. Oh, and folks, if you're watching this, let me tell you that this book was written by Wendy Lodger, and it was illustrated by Yusuf Shamari.
All right, Eric, go ahead and read this book to us.
Okay then, here we go. Taylor Allison Swift was born on December 13, 1989, in West Reading, Pennsylvania. Her parents named her after James Taylor, a famous musician.
Just like me. Because I'm a nice Canadian singer from Vancouver, Canada. I always do pop music, even jazz, especially swing, and others.
Good for you. Anyways. A lot of love surrounded by Taylor and her little brother, Austin. The Swifts did many activities as a family. They spent time reading books, visiting new places, and having fun outside. Christmas was one of Taylor's favorite holidays. And what made the holiday season even more exciting was that her family lived on a Christmas tree farm. Christmas tree farm? Wait a minute, I'm confused.
What's up, Eric? What's the matter?
Does it even make sense? All it's because of Christmas tree farm and this book? Gee, I didn't realize if this book that would include a building of Christmas tree farm. But I thought if there is no animals in this.
Well, if you said Christmas tree farm, there is some farm animals in this, because, I knew, if they are not dangerous.
Shut up, you son of a bitch! There is no farm animals at the Christmas tree farm! It's only a book!
No sphincter. But I knew, if there is something going on, in the book.
Oh, really? What does it say?
I really love Christmas. I wish it was all year round.
Well, so do we. Everybody loves Christmas. Anyways, moving on. Everyone pitched in at Christmas time. Taylor's dad mowed the fields on his tractor. Taylor's job, picking praying mantis egg pods off the trees. The Swifts didn't want anyone to get a buggy surprise on Christmas morning. As a kid, Taylor tried lots of different things. She rode horses, she acted in plays, she wrote poetry. But when she learned how to play the guitar, she knew she had found her passion.
Guitar reminds me of Elvis Presley. Because I knew if Elvis would have a guitar throughout the albums that he did.
Yup. Just like I did a debut album, all the way up to higher, especially singles.
That's correct.
What about me?
Well, obviously, maybe someday if Hasbro, even Hasbro Studios, especially some record labels would might even sign up, that is for all of us. But, maybe, who knows. Anyways. When Taylor has a goal, nothing stops her. She was a big fan of country superstars Faith Hill and Shania Twain, and she discovered that both musicians had started their careers in Memphis, I mean Nashville, Tennessee. That was all 10 years old Taylor needed to know. She asked her parents to take her to Nashville. She asked them every day, and finally, when she was 11, it happened. Her mom took Taylor and Austin there for spring break. They drove up and down Music Row, an area with country music recording studios and businesses. While Taylor's mom and brother waited in the car, Taylor ran into the offices of various record labels and handed out CDs she'd made of her music. Taylor performed anywhere that would have her, including fairs, festivals, and ball games. But sometimes following dreams means doing things other people don't understand. Girls at school were mean to Taylor. Her classmates thought it was weird to like country music so much. This made Taylor sad, but it didn't stop her from doing what she loved. When Taylor was 13, something incredible happened. RCA Records wanted to work with her. Taylor and her family said goodbye to Pennsylvania and moved to Nashville. Her dream of being a country music star was about to come true.
Hey, wait a minute. RCA Records wanted to work with Taylor Swift. Wait a minute. I thought if Universal Music Group did work with her, especially Republic Records and Big Machine.
Well yeah, Big Machine Records, even Republic Records did work with her, on the albums, throughout the years that she did. Anyways, on to the next page. For Taylor, writing songs was just as important as singing them, but because she was young, the record company wanted her to sing other people's songs, and they thought she should wait until she was older, before she made her own album. Taylor didn't agree. One night, Taylor performed at Nashville's Bluebird Cafe. She sang some of her own songs, and some songs from other singers. She caught the eye of a music executive in the crowd, who was forming a new record label. Guess who he signed up to make an album? Taylor Swift.
But I thought I was the one that I would make an album, since Reprise Records did sign me up for this. What the heck?
Take it easy, Michael. I knew, if Reprise Records did sign you up, so that way, if you did made a debut album, all the way to higher, that is from last year. Remember?
Oh, right. Never mind. Eric, you know what to do.
I'm on it. Taylor's debut album, Taylor Swift, came out when she was just 16. She was excited every time she heard her songs on the radio. Her next album, Fearless, was the top-selling record of the year and made Taylor a huge star. Taylor is fearless. When she went on her first concert tour, she took the music world by storm. One of Taylor's biggest strengths is storytelling. Her songs tell stories that...
That, what? You just did stop writing.
Oops, sorry, I almost forgot. Anyways, as what I'm saying. Many people can relate too. Taylor wrote all the songs on her third album, Speak Now. Listening to a Taylor Swift album is like hearing her diary being sung out loud. Many of Taylor's songs are inspired by her life, like The Best Day, a song about growing up in a loving family and having a supportive mom. Taylor and her mom, Andrea, are very close. They talk about everything. No one has known Taylor longer, or knows her better, than her mom. Trying new things and taking risks is important to Taylor. Even through country music, was her first love. She took a big chance and recorded a pop album called 1989. and it was the best-selling album of the year. Taylor never lets anything hold her back from creating music she loves. Taylor also loves sharing things with her fans. They know that her lucky number is 13. She often hides clues and symbols in her music and videos. For a few of her albums, she surprised special groups of fans by inviting them to secret parties to listen to the album before anyone else. They got to hang out at her house, meet her family, and even bake cookies together. When Taylor likes something, she tells everyone about it. One thing she really likes, cats.
Wait a minute. Taylor likes cats? Gah, I am allergic to cats.
Gesundheit.
Thanks.
Taylor has a big reputation for speaking out against racial injustice and for encouraging people to vote. She stands up for other artists and herself, even when it's tough. She's not just a superstar, she's a trailblazer. Taylor's hard work has paid off. Her albums have sold millions of copies. She has won multiple Grammys. She's traveled around the world and made people happy with her music. What will she do next? When you're Taylor Swift, the sky's the limit.
So, tell us. What do you think of this Golden Book biography? Let us know in the comments on what you think of this book.
Yeah, and be sure to check out the trailer of the concert film, called Taylor Swift, The Eras Tour, in which would be coming to theaters, beginning next month. Click the link in the description, so you can watch the trailer.
And be sure to like, and of course, be sure to subscribe. And don't forget to follow Joshua Ashby on Twitter. And most importantly, we will see you in the next video.
This video was produced with the Government of Canada. The Canadian Film or Video Production Tax Credit.